respiratory system is, initially we have to inhale the fresh air into the lungs and exchange of oxygen for carbon dioxide and exhale the stale air. Stale air means nothing but the remaining air inside the lungs, we call it as stale air. So that both the things has to be done in rhythmically. So we have inspiration and expiration. Just a moment. Okay. Next, coming to the organs of the respiratory system. So we call this respiratory system as respiratory tract. So it will be a continuous tract starting from the external nostrils till the lungs. So nostrils, nasal cavity, we have the pharynx, next larynx, trachea, bronchial tubes and lungs. So in this picture, you can able to see that. So here we have the nostrils. We also call it as nares. This is the nasal cavity and this is the pharynx. In the pharynx, we have three parts. So one is nasopharynx, oropharynx and laryngopharynx. And next, this is the trachea. So next, larynx. And after pharynx, we have this larynx. After larynx, we have this trachea. Trachea will be divided into two primary bronchus. So, and from the primary bronchus, we get the secondary bronchus. From the secondary, we get the tertiary. From the tertiary, we get the respiratory bronchus. And finally, these respiratory bronchus will end up in the balloon-like structures called alveoli. So, what is the lungs is actually the bronchial tree and the alveoli. Together, we call it as lungs. So, coming to the combining forms, alveolo, which means alveolus or air. Anthraco means coal or, coal. So, for example, anthracosis, coal disease. Usually, the person who is working in the coal mines, they usually get the respiratory problem called anthracosis. Etilo means incomplete. Broncho means bronchus. So, these we also call it as air tubes. And bronchio is also bronchus. Bronchiolo is bronchiole, which is the smaller bronchus. And corneo means dust. Diaphragmato, which means diaphragm, the partition which is splitting the thorax and the abdomen, we call it as diaphragm. And epiglotto, above the larynx, we have the protrusion. So if the epiglottis closes while we are eating and drinking, when we are breathing, the epiglottis will open. Laryngo means larynx or voice box. Because our voice is produced from larynx. While you are talking, if you touch nearby the larynx, you can feel the vibration in the larynx. Lobo means lobe. Naso, which means nose. Ortho, which means straight. Oxo or oxy, which means upright. Pharyngo means oxygen. Sorry, pharyngo means pharynx. Oxio means oxygen. Pleuro means pleura. Pneumo means lungs. Pneumono is also lungs and air. Pulmono means lungs. So, for example, pulmonology, study of lungs. Rhino is nose. Naso or rhino, both means nose only. Sinuso, which means sinus. The spaces present inside the nose, inside the sphenoid, ethmoid, frontal and maxillary, we call it as sinuses. Spiro means breathing. Spirometry. So, the process of measuring the breathing, we call it as spirometry. Tracheo means trachea or windpipe. Capnia, which means carbon dioxide, and ectasis, which means dilation. Dilation means enlargement of the tubes, and osmia means smell. Phonia is breathing, and osmia is smell, phonia is voice, and penia is breathing, and tisis. Tisis means spitting. So, for example, hemoptysis, spitting of blood. Thorax, which means chest. Coming to the anatomy and physiology, why do we want to respire? Means we need oxygen for each and every part of the cell. With the oxygen only, the ATP will get produced. ATP, we call it as energy currency of our body. So the respiratory system works in conjunction with the cardiovascular system to meet their needs. So the respiratory system will make the blood oxygenated and removes the carbon dioxide from the blood. But the oxygenated blood will be pumped to all the body parts by the heart and returning the deoxygenated blood to the lungs by the heart. So both things will be done by the heart. So always the respiratory system and cardiovascular system will work conjointly and coordinatedly. So respiration is actually a continuous process. We cannot stop our respiration. Continuously we have to respire. We divide the respiration majorly into, actually it has two parts only. Ventilation. Ventilation, we have two types. One is inhalation, other one is exhalation. Ventilation means the air will be moving in and out. First one is inhalation. So when the air flows from outside the environment till the alveoli, we also call it as air sacs. That we call it as inhalation. Exhalation means when the air in the lungs is flowing outside, so which consists of more amount of carbon dioxide. In inspiration, it has inhalation, it consists of more amount of oxygen. So external respiration and internal respiration. So I'll tell you the concept. Do you all have a pen and paper with you? If you read the whole concept, you'll get confused. I'll explain you in an easy way. Take the pen and paper and draw three rectangular boxes, one after the other. Three rectangular boxes. One rectangular box and below that another rectangular box and that too below another rectangular box. Okay. Hello. Have you done it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Write in the first box, lungs. Inside the box, lungs. And in the second box, blood. Inside the third box, body, B-O-D-Y. Body or cells or tissues. You can write any of the three. Okay, done with that?
Yes, ma'am.
Could I proceed?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Draw a line from lungs to blood. Draw an arrow from lungs to blood. Okay. So, when we are inhalation, we also call it as inspiration. While we are inspiration, are inhaling the air from atmosphere into the lungs, we have more amount of oxygen in the air. Okay. And less amount of carbon dioxide. More amount of oxygen and less amount of carbon dioxide. So, now, which gas will go from lungs to blood? Which gas will go from lungs to blood? Anyone? Oxygen, obviously. Just write nearby the line O2. So, because higher concentration is O2 in the lungs. So, obviously, the O2 will go into blood, from lungs to blood. And now, in the blood, we have more amount of carbon dioxide and less amount of oxygen. So, just draw a line from blood to lungs. Another line. Blood to lungs. So, now you tell me what it will go from blood to lungs.
Carbon dioxide.
Yeah, obviously, carbon dioxide. So, here the exchange of gases was over. Oxygen was taken from lungs to the blood and carbon dioxide was being jumped exchanged from blood to lungs. Yeah, it was perfect till here. And next, come to blood to tissues or blood to the body. Now, the blood consists of more amount of oxygen. So, now draw a line from blood to tissues. What will go from blood to tissues now? Oxygen or carbon dioxide? Which one?
Oxygen.
Yeah, obviously oxygen. Very good. O2. Just write O2. And coming to the next thing, and draw a line from tissues to blood or body to blood. Now, what it will go from body or tissues to blood? What it will go?
Carbon dioxide.
Super. Carbon dioxide. It will go from. So, here the exchange of gases was done. Finally, from the atmosphere, the oxygen was reaching to tissues or cells. and the carbon dioxide from the tissues, it is reaching to outside the atmosphere. So likewise, the exchange of gases takes place. We have the respiration two parts. One is external respiration and other one is internal respiration. External respiration is the exchange of gas between lungs to blood and blood to lungs. So that first two boxes between the lungs and blood, that exchange we call it as external respiration. For that, I told you that whole story. Got it? And what is internal respiration is from blood to tissues and tissues to blood. There the exchange of the gases, we call it as internal respiration. Got it?
Yes, ma'am.
Any doubts?
No, ma'am.
We got the point.
No, ma'am.
What is the external
respiration? Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Same respiratory system organs. I already told you nasal cavity, pharynx, larynx, trachea, bronchi, primary bronchi. From the primary, secondary, secondary to tertiary, tertiary to respiratory. Finally, it will end in alveoli. So bronchial tree and the alveoli together, we call it as lungs. First one is nasal cavity. So the air will enter from this openings. We call it as nares. Nares or nostrils, both are same. It will enter into this cavity. We call this as nasal cavity, which is separated by a septum. So the two nose was separated by a septum. We have only one nose, but our single nose is separated by a partition. We call that partition as septum. And after here, you can see this nasal cavity and this oral cavity is separated by this palate. So till here, we call it as hard palate, and backside, we call it as soft palate. Okay. And cilia, inside the nose we have hairs. Why do we have hairs? Is to trap the dust particles, unwanted substance, or any thing like abnormal mucus collections. Those things will be collected in the nose by the cilia. And the wall of the nasal septum is always lined by mucus membrane. And also we have flexible cartilage. We call that cartilage as elastic cartilage. So we can stretch it. We can stretch our nose. And nasal cavity. So much of the nasal cavity is covered by mucous membrane only, because the mucus is thick and sticky secretions of the membrane. So why do we have a mucus? Is always it has to humidify the hair, warm the air, and by trapping the dust and bacteria. And we have the capillaries inside the mucous membrane, which always will, because of the capillaries only, the air will get warm and humidified. Capillaries means smaller blood vessels. Paranasal sinuses. So nearby the nose, we have the open spaces, spaces inside the bone. Those we call it as paranasal sinus. Para means beside. So beside the nose we have. Why do we have the holes or spaces inside the bone? Is to provide echo sound during the production. And also resonance to voice. For example, the auditorium. So in the auditorium, we cannot hear the resound because of their construction. Likewise, because of our paranasal sinuses, we cannot hear our sound like a resound. And these are paranasal sinuses. You can able to see. This is frontal sinus. This is ethmoid sinus. So sinus means the hollow spaces inside the bones. And you can see here, nasopharynx, and this is the eustachian tube. The eustachian tube is the connection between the nasopharynx and middle ear. So that's why if we have any cold, very much cold, that will get into our ear also. Sometimes the tympanic membrane will burst also. And this is oropharynx. This is epiglottis. And this is laryngopharynx. So this is vocal cords. With the vibration of this vocal cords only, we can able to speak. And here we have the esophagus on the back side and trachea on the front. And this is larynx, front part of the larynx. Front part of the larynx is covered by two cartilage. One is thyroid cartilage and other one is cricoid cartilage. So pharynx, I already told you, nasopharynx, oropharynx and laryngopharynx. So the air will cross from the nasal cavity to the nasopharynx, oropharynx and laryngopharynx. It will cross all those things and enter into the trachea. So there are three subdivisions. Already we have seen. And tonsils. So we have the lymphatic tissue inside the mouth region, nearby the mouth region, nearby the nasal cavity and oral cavity. We call that as tonsils. There are three pairs of tonsils. One is adenoids. Other one is palatine, which is present nearby the palate. Lingual, present nearby the lung, tongue. What is this is? It will trap any unwanted bacteria or virus that is coming through the food, air and water. So that lymphoid tissue we will be having. If it is present nearby the tongue, we call it as lingual tonsil. If it is present nearby the palate, we call it as palatine tonsil. If it is present nearby the throat, we call it as adenoids. So, eustachian tube. Eustachian tube is the connection between the nasopharynx and the middle ear. Why do we need to have a connection between the nasopharynx and the ear is, middle ear is, to equalize the pressure. For example, continuously we are taking air through the nose. In order to equalize that pressure, it will let some amount of air from the other way. So to equalize the air pressure only, we have the eustachian tube. So this is the eustachian tube, you can see here. And larynx, we commonly called voice box, which is the muscular tube present between the pharynx and trachea. So this is the larynx. And it contains vocal cords. Yes. So the walls of the larynx is made up of cartilage, and that cartilage was held by ligaments and muscles. We have the two important cartilage. One is thyroid cartilage and other one is cricoid cartilage. So thyroid cartilage, we also call it as Adam's apple because it is very much developed in males. While they are speaking also, you can see that prominence. So that will be moving up and down. So that is thyroid cartilage. So that was the male characteristic feature, having Adam's apple. Vocal cords, which are like membranous foldings. So when the air is going through these foldings, that will produce sound. That sound was converted to voice. So that we call it as vocal cords. We also call the vocal cords as glottis. So this is the vocal cords. This is the larynx. Larynx, vocal cords, and epiglottis. And epiglottis. Usually, epiglottis is present above the larynx. So, when we are taking the food and water, the epiglottis will close the larynx to allow the food and water to fall into the esophagus. While we are breathing, the epiglottis will open to allow the air into the trachea. Okay. And trachea. So, from the larynx, we have a windpipe. We call it as trachea. So this trachea was being encircled by the cartilaginous rings in order to prevent the trachea from collapsing. Because we are taking air into the lungs in order to prevent collapsing. It is around 4 inches in length. So here we have the larynx. So this is thyroid cartilage. This is cricoid cartilage. So this whole together we call it as larynx. This is hyoid bone. And this is trachea, which are surrounded by cartilaginous rings. Here we have the right and left main bronchus. So trachea is composed of two things. One is smooth muscles and other one is cartilaginous rings. So which is lined with mucous membrane and cilia. So inside the trachea also we have the cilia. Cilia means finger like, hair like projections. So where and all we have the cilia. There it is for cleaning the air, warming and moisturizing the air. Bronchial tree. So from the trachea, we have the primary bronchi. From the primary bronchi, we have the secondary bronchi. From the secondary, we have the tertiary. From the tertiary bronchi, we have the pulmonary bronchi. And finally, which will end in the alveolar. So this entire thing, we call it as bronchial tree. And these are the alveoli. So you can see this. These are like balloon-like structures. When the air is finally going into these balloon-like structures, that will enlarge. So approximately we have 150 millions of alveoli in each lung. Respiratory membrane. So what is respiratory membrane is? These are capillaries actually. Capillary means smaller blood vessels. These only will bring the blood nearby the alveoli. So when the blood is bringing nearby the alveoli, here the exchange will take place between the blood and the lungs. So the respiratory membrane means this alveolar wall plus this capillary wall together will make the respiratory membrane. There, between that membrane only, the exchange of gases should take place. And lungs. Each is total, lungs is nothing but collection of bronchi, bronchioles and alveoli. We have two lungs. Right lung has three lobes and left lung has two lobes. You can see in this picture. So this is right lung. Upper lobe, middle lobe and lower lobe. So in the left lung, we have only two lobes, upper lobe and lower lobe. Compare it to the right lung. Left lung was small because left side was being occupied by the heart. So lungs are actually the spongy tissues. So in this lungs, we have the apex. This is apex and this is base. And the contents which will enter and exit from the lungs, we call that area as hilum. In the hilum, we have bronchi, pulmonary artery, pulmonary vein. And lungs are protected externally by a covering. That covering name is pleura, which is double layer. So outer layer, we call it as parietal pleura. And the inner layer, which is very close to the lungs, we call it as visceral pleura. And between the parietal and visceral pleura, we have a space. We call that as pleural cavity. Inside the pleural cavity, we have the fluid called pleural fluid. So that fluid actually lacks like a shock absorption while breathing. So this is the lung, apex, base and hilum. And this is the upper lobe, middle lobe and lower lobe. Here we have the upper lobe and lower lobe. And this is the hilum part. And here we have the diaphragm. So coming to the PFT, pulmonary function test, which means, so the testing the lung capacity. So how much amount of air that can go into the lungs and how much amount of the air that can come out of the lungs. That testing we call it as PFT, pulmonary function test. And the person we call him as respiratory therapist. It measures two things. One is lung volumes and other one is PFT. So first one is tidal volume. What is tidal volume is? The amount of air that is going in and out of the lungs. When the person is breathing normally, then the normal inspiration and expiration, we call it as tidal volume. And inspiratory reserve volume, which means the amount of air additionally to the tidal volume, we call it as inspiratory reserve volume. And the amount of air that can additionally expire after the tidal volume, we call it as expiratory reserve volume. For example, in yoga and all, they'll ask you to breathe more. So breathe. So that is actually inspiratory reserve volume. And also to exhale, they'll be keep on telling. So that is expiratory reserve volume. And residual volume, even though after the expiratory reserve volume also, always some amount of air will be there in the lungs itself. So that actually we call it as residual volume. So why do we have air in the lungs is always because in order to prevent the lungs from collapsing. And next, capacities. Capacities means inspiratory capacity, which is tidal volume plus inspiratory reserve volume. And functional residual capacity is expiratory reserve volume plus residual volume. Vital capacity, which is inspiratory reserve volume, tidal volume plus expiratory reserve volume. And coming to the total lung capacity, inspiratory reserve volume, tidal volume, you have to sum all the volumes. Then you get total lung capacity. So diaphragm. So coming to the inhalation, the very important muscle for inhalation is diaphragm. And diaphragm, intercostals, so which is the chief inspiratory muscles. So which creates the negative pressure inside the lungs. So obviously the air will move from the positive pressure into the lungs. So that's how the diaphragm will help. And intercostal muscles. This actually will increase the chest capacity by lifting the ribs. So it also increases the negative pressure. So the air will be coming from the atmosphere into the lungs. So you can see in this experiment. This is actually the balloons. So this bag, assume this balloons as lungs and this has diaphragm. So when we are pulling the diaphragm, so the air will be going into the lungs. Means, so assume this rubber tube is the diaphragm. So when we are pulling the diaphragm, the air will be going from the atmosphere into this balloons. The same thing will be happening in with our body. When we are contracting the diaphragm, when we are making the diaphragm to flat, the air will be going from the atmosphere to the lungs. And these are the intercostal muscles, which helps to enlarge the chest cavity by raising the thorax. So exhalation means normally bringing the air from the lungs to the atmosphere, we call it as exhalation. For forceful exhalation, usually the abdominal muscles will work more. For example, if you want to expire forcefully, you can only check. So the stomach, you have to press your stomach more hardly. So respiratory rate. So respiratory rate is the respiratory rate means the number of times the person is respiring per minute. We call it as respiratory rate. So for example, if these 12 to 20 breaths per minute. So if the carbon dioxide is more in the blood, then the respiratory rate will increase. If the carbon dioxide is less in the blood, the respiration rate will decrease. So for the newborn, the respiratory rate is more. It is 30 to 60 breaths per minute. For 16 years, it is 18 to 30 breaths per minute. And for an adult, it is 12 to 20.